yes. Oh, you're okay, little guy. Okay. He doesn't do as well with bigger pups. Once he gets comfortable, he's fine. Sense. She doesn't learn to develop and do those things on her own accord. So that's partly why she doesn't listen to you, and partly why she just pulls towards whatever her nose is going, because it's what's interesting to her, and she no longer registers the force on the leash as anything important. So as far as like the walking behavior and recall goes, we're gonna start by teaching her what that leash pressure means. Set boundary, and I want to try to keep the leash loose the rest of the entire time. And my goal is to get to the end of the block with as little input on my end as possible, and let the leash do the work and let her figure it out. So what'll happen is I'll just try to go a constant pace. I'll let her just kind of smell whatever she wants, and then as soon as I get too far, then the leash will trigger, or if she gets too far, the leash will actually trigger, and I just go off of that. I'll either use pressure if she's falling behind, or patience, so that way she can actually learn to do things on her own accord, or maybe a combination of both, it just depends. So here's a good situation, right? She's starting to lag behind because of all the smells off to the side. I'm going to try to keep a nice consistent pace for her, so that way as soon as she knows, very good. A lot of people like to control a dog by force instead of patience. It works generally faster in the beginning, but what ends up happening is you end up micromanaging so much that they don't do anything herself. Mm-hmm. Good girl. Yep. And all I did was be patient until the line was loose again, and then we just started going. So I use... Yeah. So a lot of it, especially if she is very scent motivated, is getting her out and actually letting her smell and explore things, because that helps with her mental stimulus. If you are always pulling her away from everything, it can cause frustration, and also it doesn't give her that mental stimulus that you want her to have while she's out on a walk. And you can kind of see now, she's kind of going the way that we're going, and I haven't pulled the leash but twice. And I haven't even really pulled it. She did. And then as soon as the pressure is there, let her sniff around, and then I'm gonna go. Good girl. Very good. So you see there, the mark timing is as soon as I pull that leash, and as soon as she feels it and then comes with me or pays attention to me, that's when I would shoot. Good girl. Very good. Very good. Very good. Hi. So because she's kind of looking around, saw all the different sounds and smells going on, she may be too anxious for a treat. She may not. Also, I'm a stranger. Good girl. All right, and one more time going back. Just text it down for me so that way I have the time to make the reference. And what we'll probably need to do is then when you have no pressure again, just start walking. Good girl, very good. So she can pick up the lesson pretty quick, but it's gonna be on you to just kind of continue it on. Same handkerchief. She's not as curious the second time, because she got to smell things the first time. Good. And then follows you on her own, that's when she's learning and developing, right? So just wait. Very good. And then say out loud what she's pulling, why she's pulling. Yep. Very good. Perfect. And then turn around and start walking back. And do you see how less effort that is for both of you and less frustrating as well? Very good. Yep, she's doing good. As far as the jumping goes with a lot of puppies, that's going to be self-control and social work, which we'll be able to work. You'll want to teach her patience. It's okay. Patience and self-control and frustration are things that, you know, you have to teach a puppy over time anyways. But like I said, it's kind of one of those things that the less that you do, the more that she has to think about what she should be doing. And then, because now she's actively thinking about a situation and what to do in it, instead of just doing a command, she's learning and developing faster. Very good. She looks good. Can kind of see the difference already, even though we've gone up and down this block now the third time. The first time is just going to always be more exciting because of all the new smells. Oh, it's mostly done here, and then the social works outside. Usually I work in parks and things like that. The main thing is we start off with basics and everything like this, usually indoors, so that way there's less distractions. And then move outside to do a lot of the practices and natural work. Very good. Mm-hmm. probably put that on back burner of her mind, that it's there. There's something of value on the other end of the scale. So everything distraction-wise is going to weigh down like a scale, right? And now, as soon as I get her attention, I'm going to reel her in by encouraging her to come back and follow for the treat. So that way she kind of gets the whole feeling of the word come command. So all I'm doing is, since she knows that we have a treat now, she has ran through the come command once. Libby, yes, come, 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 wait, come, perfect. And I want to see her reaction. Come back around. Wait. And now just stand right there. Ask her to wait. And now ask her to come to you. See? Recall. We did recall the same way as we did with the treat, but instead of the treat, we just used you as the reward that she already wants. So instead of trying to pull a dog in, we're kind of winding them up like a spring, so when they hear come, we just release that spring because they want to come to us. It's a lot easier than trying to recall it by like pulling people in. Yeah, she does. And you can kind of see that with the separation anxiety a little bit there. She at first just stood and waited, expected you back, didn't come back. She cried a little bit. Actually, she cried a little bit, she tried to get to you. Generally, what ends up happening in situations like that at home is because at that point, when she is starting to act out and physically frustrated, is when she can't get to you, and so she has to take that physical frustration out on someone else. So a lot of this, so we can easily kind of get her fixed and into, but it's going to have to be on your end to kind of maybe work together to try to change your lifestyle a little bit for her, at least in the beginning, until she grows and develops and matures a bit more. I like we're talking, definitely the walking part, so you're not always pulling your arm for no reason and pulling her, but you're like waking up maybe an hour or two earlier for a longer walk, and so that way she's sleepier, staying out later at night with her to hang out and do things. Because what ends up happening when we're not alone, when we're not at home, she builds up that kind of wanting to do something with somebody. And so as soon as we get back, usually that excitement and energy is there, you know, dogs are jumping and all that stuff. As soon as their owners come back home, they're excited and they want that engagement. So we really want her to be able to hold out and wait for that engagement, either by understanding that it's going to happen later, so she doesn't freak out, and giving her something else to put her mind on, so that way when she does start thinking about it, she can direct herself. And lastly, on top of those things, giving her own daily routine so her life doesn't revolve around routine. So it's a lot, but we'll definitely work on it. Right. So now for one more exercise, I want you to go ahead and just walk away from her. Are we blinking still or no?
Yes.
Okay, good. So go ahead and walk away from her. I'm just going to hold her here. And then you just stand there.
face to face in this trashy bar. Another glass and I am going places. Makes me laugh about the irony of everything.
Good girl.
I like the way you're thinking. I don't really care about the music on the dance floor. I don't really mind. All the smoke is in the bathroom. I don't care at all, baby. You got my attention.
Same thing, go around the fence.
So you were saying, oh no, I don't see the logic of things. It's quite a
and then just wait there. Okay, let me go ahead and come back.
Makes total sense when you're next to me.
Let me go ahead and call her to you. Good. Hi, how are you doing? Aww. Oh, I know. You want to say hi. Good girl. Come on. Come on, guys. Good listen. I know, I didn't forget you, buddy. So a general way that you can tell from physical symptoms of signs of anxiety is the rapid breathing that she has, as well as her crying. And you can also see that her walking behavior seems a lot more erratic as well. She's not just pulling as before to get used to all the smells, but now she's kind of looking around as well. Good girl, come on. Good girl. Oh my goodness. There you go. Down. Oh, you're okay. She's just got overwhelmed, that's all. There you go. Down. Oh, you're so excited. Here, I'll let you untangle that one. There you go. Oh, they're so happy. You guys are so happy. Hi, this is a new pup. This is... Hi, how are you doing? Good. You want to... Thanks. This is lit. This is Libby. She's very friendly. I know you. There you go. Easy. No. She's just excited. Right now, you just kind of let it play out. Yeah. Oh, there you go. There you go. Well, it might help that she's like a puppy too. Yeah.
This one looks so afraid.
Aww.
Oh my gosh, I'm sorry.
It's okay. She just got a little overwhelmed. Aww.
Hello.
There you go. Aww. Yeah, no problem. I'll let you guys get going. Take care. It did good. Oh, come on, Libby. I know you got excited. It's okay, baby. Yeah. You're okay. See? You're friendly. I know. It's a big dog.
It's okay.
Come here. Let me untangle you. There you go. Oh, now you're tangled. Okay. Alright. Come on. It's okay. Let's go. Good job. Hold on, Libby. Libby. Her nose gets some fresh air and everything, so she's not just focused on you not being there. Also to get some exercise out for her, as the more tired she is, the easier it'll be for her to relax. It's really important that you pick and choose your moments to work on certain things. Like right now, because I have the puppies with me as well, we're not really concentrating too much on her leash work and her behavior. We're still trying to keep some things consistent, as in like not trying to let her make too much progress at when she's pulling, and only making progress when the leash is nice and loose. But for the most part, we're just concentrating on letting her just get out and about and use her nose. That way she can get some energy and some anxiety out of her. Good girl. Very good. Good girl. Yeah, you're doing so good. With me? With me? Very good.